Morning all, this is Brad here, sunny Sherwood Park, Alberta. Thought some of you might like to go for a drive with me today. And Junior. Junior's a 49 International. Let's see if I can get a better shot. I'm not a very good videographer. I'm using the forward camera here, because what I'm going to do is mount the camera to a little mount on the phone mount, really, that I've put on the back window. Let's see if you can see that. And we'll see how this goes. And that should work. Something like that. We'll give it a try. The neighborhood here. A few minutes, such a beautiful day. This is a 1949 International KB2. K series was 1941 to 1949. After the war, they started the KBs. They put some chrome on the grill. That's about the only difference. Bits of chrome here and there. This is a 214 cubic inch flathead six, all original. And the transmission is a 3-speed on the floor. A lot of them are on the column as well, 3 speeds. You just didn't get into the 4 speeds until you got into the, I think, 3s, maybe 5s. Transmissions aren't synchronized, especially, well, I think there might be some synchro between 3 and 2, but definitely nothing for 1. So you have to kind of adjust your engine speed to do the shifts, and the guys who used to drive these a lot probably got pretty good at it. That's not me. Drive is very seldom, usually once or twice a year. Sits in the garage and collects all the cardboard boxes and models to go to the scouts, and a couple times a year we take it for a drive on a nice day to the recycle location. So no, I don't get a lot of practice in here, but it's fun to drive, especially on really nice days. You go nice and slow. 35 miles an hour is a pretty nice cruising speed in this. Original. metropolis of Half Moon Lake Estates, a subdivision on Half Moon Lake. Cascade works some of the time. This is my second attempt at this video. First one, Sharon pointed out immediately that I should have cleaned the front window. Some details. You know, us guys aren't good at details. Hopefully you can see okay. signal lights in. The truck is still 6-volt positive ground. I'd like to have everything as original as possible, but driving the roads, of course, needs signal lights, so it's not easy to find a LED lights that are positive ground, so I'd actually built them, put them right into the front lenses and existing running lights and some tail lights, so that's working out pretty well. I never got around to putting a little indicator on the light dash for the signal lights being on, so I just put a little Pezio buzzer in there just so I don't forget. Sometimes it gets a little noisy. Maybe one of those guys. Now we're back in the hood. Enjoyed the drive. That's what it was like a long time ago. Except the roads are probably all gravel and you wouldn't have been able to hear me with all the rattles. Sound. Thanks for coming.